You snuck up on me. Hi, I'm Jessie. I'm an educator at the Perot Museum. I'm not at the museum today, but I'm taking a hike at this wonderful nature preserve right here in the Metroplex, and I'm checking on our camera trap. This is a motion sensor camera that picks up images of animals running around the habitat, especially at night when they're most active. So it's a great tool for scientists to use to understand how animals are interacting with their environment. Camera traps are a great
way for scientists to Look, our camera trap caught me talking about camera traps.
What's another way scientists can study animals without actually observing their everyday movements?
Scat chat.
Scat is the term used by scientists to describe solid waste materials excreted by animals. That's right, folks. Overcome any queasiness because we are going to learn the scoop on poop. By using Scat and our camera trap, we can better understand the community of consumers that live in our forest ecosystem. What is an ecosystem? An ecosystem includes all the living organisms in a given area interacting with each other and with their non-living components, like sun, soil, water, and weather. Let's make this a little bit more interesting. I'll go look for some scat, and you try to guess who made the poo. Awesome, our first scat of the day. It's pretty small, so I assume the animal must be too. Looks like it contains a lot of plant material. Any guesses? Let's take a look at our camera trap footage for some hints. Did you guess our eastern cottontail rabbit? Look how high they jump. Maybe two males fighting for territory. Rabbits are herbivores, or only eat plants. Check out this skull. See the incisors or front teeth? They're specialized for snipping. See these flat molars? They're great for grinding. These teeth are perfectly specialized for eating plant material. Shall we scat daddle? This looks interesting. Much bigger than the rabbit scat. I see mesquite seeds and some hair. This scat must have been left in the fall when mesquite trees are dropping seed pods. What do you think? Did you guess raccoon? Looks like this one might be digging for invertebrates. Eyes in front, likes to hunt. Unlike that rabbit skull we looked at whose eyes are on the side and likes to hide. Jaw contains sharp canines for tearing meat, but broad molars in the back for chewing plants and bugs. Must be an omnivore. Is that scat? Oh, cool, it's actually an oak apple gall. Galls are actually constructed of oak leaf tissue that had been hijacked by a gall wasp insect. The gall wasp female will lay her egg in the leaf, and the leaf responds by forming this gall. The gall protects the larva developing inside. My scat dar senses something this away. Whoa, look closely. This scat has insect exoskeletons. Must be an insectivore that recently enjoyed a bug buffet. Any ideas who made it? Whoa, look there, a Gulf Coast toad. We must have scared it from its hiding spot. Do you think it made the scat? Because toads, like most amphibians, are sensitive to dehydration, they are typically more active at night when it is cooler and more humid. Don't worry, you can't get warts from toads. Those bumps help keep the skin moist and some secrete toxins for protection. You will notice from the skull that toads have no teeth. They must swallow their insect prey whole. Well, that makes sense that we found insect parts in its scat. Hey, spider, get out of my shot. Is that scat? What? A plastic bottle. Come on, people. Clean up after yourself. My scatty senses are pulling me this away. Whoa! Look at the size of that scat. I sure am seeing a lot of hair. Any guesses? I think you're right. It's a coyote. Check this out. We actually caught one in the act of making scat. Totally busted. Eyes in front, likes to hunt. Look at those round canines for grabbing, and blade-like premolars and molars for shearing and crushing bone. Although coyotes are in the order carnivora, they behave more like omnivores, eating a variety of food items. Check out these samples of coyote scat I have. This one is full of grasshopper parts. This one is full of seeds. And this one is full of ketchup packets? Gross. You're probably wondering, why does this lady have scat samples? Great question. Meet Tim. Tim is our teaching collection coordinator. He preserves scat he finds in nature. He's weird, but that's why we love him. That's not like any scat we've seen today. It's mostly white and very liquidy. What do you think? Let's consult the camera one last time. Wait for it. A screech owl! We often see this owl on camera, diving towards the ground, trying to catch its favorite food, roaches. Check out all the space in this skull dedicated to its eye sockets. Owls have a really good sense of sight and hearing. Hope you enjoyed this segment of Scat Chat. Now it's your turn to find Scat and learn more about the ecosystems around you. Happy scatting!
Stepped in Scat. Nice.